Do you feel lazy? Do you feel the fear of failure? Do you want to know one common habit which almost every successful person shares on this planet? Hey guys, welcome to When to Read What. And I have found the most appropriate answer to about three questions in the book How I Raised Myself from Failure to Success in Selling, written by Mr. Frank Bedker. Now, getting straight to the first question, it was the time when Mr. Bedker was 19 years old and he was playing for Johnstown Baseball Club in Pennsylvania. And his life was about to change as his manager had fired him. Mr. Bedker went on to ask manager why, to which the manager replied that he was playing like a veteran. He was dragging his body all over the field and he was lazy. After listening to this, Mr. Bedker went on to admit that he was nervous and so scared that he was trying to hide from the crowd and also from his teammates. That is when the manager went on to give him some advice which changed Mr. Bedker's life forever. And here is that advice. The manager told Mr. Bedker, "Frank, it will never work. That is the thing that is holding you down. Whatever you do after you leave here, for heaven's sake, wake yourself up and put some life and enthusiasm into your work." And this very advice went on to become the foundation of Mr. Bedker's success in selling industry. And in the book, Mr. Bedker has also went on to reveal the secret of being enthusiastic, which is to act enthusiastic. And if you are enthusiastic about anything, then it is almost impossible to be nervous, scared, or lazy while doing it. Now, this brings us to the second question, which is, what about fear of failure? So, on this planet, most of us feel the fear of failure. And to overcome it, Mr. Bedker has referred to an interview which was given by a legendary baseball player, Mr. Babe Ruth. So, here is what Mr. Rice asked Mr. Ruth. "Babe, what do you do when you get in a batting slump?" To which Mr. Ruth replied, "I just keep going up there and keep swinging at them. I know the old law of averages will hold good for me the same as it does for anybody else. If I keep having my healthy swings, if I strike out 2 or 3 times in a game, or fail to get a hit for a week, why should I worry? Let the pitchers worry. They are the guys who are gonna suffer later on." And to explain the law of averages, Mr. Bedker had tried to explain it with the help of an example of 2 baseball players. But since I'm not a very big fan of baseball, I will try to explain it with the help of an example of footballers. So here are 2 legendary footballers, Lionel Messi and Cristiano Ronaldo. And here are the stats of the numbers of goals which they have scored in UEFA Champions League till March 2020. So as you can see it on your screen, the number of goals scored by Lionel Messi are 114 in 141 matches. Whereas Cristiano Ronaldo has scored 128 goals in 169 matches. So when you look at the average, Messi's average is better than Ronaldo's. But when it comes to the number of goals scored, Ronaldo has scored more goals than Messi. And a simple reason behind this is that Ronaldo has played more number of games than Messi. So here, the key takeaway is that the more you take the risk, the better your chances of success. So here, Mr. Bedker has advised to take more risk when it comes to sales and also in your personal life. And now coming to the third question, which is one of the most common habit which almost every successful person shares on this planet. I will try to explain it with the help of example of God of cricket, Mr. Sachin Tendulkar, sir. So, it has been seen many times in practice sessions that Sachin sir keeps on practicing one fundamental shot 200 times, 300 times, or even sometimes 500 times straight. So, the basic idea behind it is that Sachin sir keeps on practicing that particular shot until it becomes natural and subconscious as breathing to him. And suppose he wasn't able to play one of his shot properly in one of his matches, then he would go back to the nets and he would keep on practicing it until he would attain a certain degree of perfection in it. If you turn the pages of history, you will find this one common habit which is shared by almost every successful person on this planet. For example, Kobe Bryant, Michael Jordan, Elon Musk, Shah Rukh Khan, Lata Mangeshkar, and you will find n number of examples who keep on going back to their fundamentals until they have mastered it. So, one of the most common habit which almost every successful person shares on this planet is that they keep going back to the fundamentals and keep on drilling until they attain a certain level of perfection in it. When to read this book? So, as you might have guessed from the title itself, that this book is written with the help of selling perspective. But here is an interesting fact that Mr. Bettger was a student of Mr. Dale Carnesser. And in the book, Mr. Bettger has shown every practical application of Dale Carnesser's principle in day-to-day life. And I have done a detailed series on how to influence and influence people written by Mr. Dale Carnesser. I will mention the link of it in the description down below. And in the book, Mr. Bettger has not only shown the practical application of Mr. Dale Carnesser's principle, but this book is also very insightful. So, for example, I remember when Mr. Bettger was watching a world champion billiards player practicing his shots. So, at the first glance, Mr. Bettger thought that the shots were so simple that even he could make them. But after observing the player for a while, Mr. Bettger realized that the player was actually practicing the ball positioning, which is done after the shot. And in the book, with the help of this example, Mr. Bettger has tried to show that your next move is much more important when it comes to selling. So throughout the book, you will find many more insights like this, which are not only useful in selling, but in your day-to-day life too. So, if you're someone who is into selling business or in selling industry, then this book can be one of the best read which you will ever find. So it is a must read for you guys. However, if you're someone who is looking for self-improvement with some minor changes in your life, then this book can be a good read for you guys. And while reading the book, you will find many more powerful insights which will help you to drastically improve your communication skills and as well as your personality. And one of the most powerful points of reading this book is that it shows the application of Mr. Dale Carnesser's principle under tough conditions which usually occur in our day-to-day life. So I hope you guys like the video. And don't forget to practice enthusiasm, taking risk, and also mastering your basic skill set. And do comment and let me know which is the most useful advice which you found in this video. And do share the video with someone who might benefit from this advice from Mr. Bettger. And if you're facing any kind of problem in your day-to-day life, then do comment it in the comment section down below. I will try to answer it via help of a book. So, until then, happy reading!